welcome to the STEM space at home, a place where you can do science and engineering projects right in the comfort of your own home. My name is Aspen Marnicki. I'm a mechanical engineer and host for today's episode, where we're going to be building our very own superhero arm. So who doesn't want to be a superhero? This seems pretty cool to me. Although, it seems like to be a superhero, you need to be bitten by a spider, come from a magical planet, or be a part of a top secret lab experiment. Well, what if I told you there was a way to turn normal human strength into superhuman strength, like Iron Man? Tony Stark was an ordinary guy who used math and science to create a superhuman, super strength flying machine called the Iron Man suit. But what if I told you the Iron Man suit wasn't so far from reality today? The Iron Man suit is called a robotic exoskeleton. Exo meaning outside. So when you put it all together, it's basically a wearable robotic skeleton on the outside of your body controlled by you. Now, when people talk about robots, it's usually in the same sentence as taking over the world, when robotic exoskeletons are the complete opposite of that, because it only works when humans and robots work together. So imagine if you had a robotic arm and instead of controlling it through a computer or a joystick, you could physically control it by moving it yourself. That's what an exoskeleton does. Right now, getting humanoid robots to move like humans is really, really difficult. And so by putting humans inside of the robots, we can help the robots move more like humans, and we can use the robot's strength to our strength and become superhumans. It can even make you 20 times stronger. The types of people that work on robotic exoskeletons are biomedical engineers. So biomedical engineers work on machines and develop new technologies in the field of biology and medicine. So they develop anything from new medical devices to artificial organs and even robotic exoskeletons like we're talking about today. So let's go ahead and stretch our biomedical engineering muscles and build our very own superhero arm modeled after the Iron Man suit. Let's start building. We're going to be building our exoskeleton hand before we work on a whole entire arm. So the materials that you're going to need for this activity are some string, tape, you can use masking tape, scotch tape, any type of tape will work, scissors, marker or pencil, something to draw with, straws, bendy straws, straight straws, any type of straws will work, and then construction paper. If you don't have construction paper, regular paper, you can try cardboard, but it might be a little harder for the cardboard to move and bend like paper would. So your mission today is to create an exoskeleton hand that can move all five fingers. All right, so the first step is that we are going to make our exoskeleton hand modeled by our very own hand. So what you're gonna need is you're gonna grab your paper, grab a marker or a pencil, and what I want you to do is I want you to trace your own hand. Bring your hand down on the paper, and then you're just gonna trace it. If you are in elementary school, I would suggest maybe asking if you can trace a parent or an adult's hand, because it's kind of hard with this activity if you have a small hand to work with, so. All right, and here's my final thing, just your hand template, and then what you're gonna do is you're gonna take some scissors, and you are going to cut this out. So the way our actual hands move are because of bones and muscles. So in order to get our paper hand to move, we need to add some bones. So for that, we're going to be using our straws. So I want you to guess how many bones are in your hand and your wrist. Do you think it's 17, 27, or 30? It's actually 27. So there's 27 bones in your hand, palm, fingers, wrist. How crazy is that? All right, so in your hand, you have bones in the palm of your hand and your fingers. So in the palm of your hand, in each, going into each finger, these bones are called your metacarpals. So that's what makes up your palm. The bones that make up your fingers are called phalanges. So in each of these four main fingers, you have three phalanges. So those are the bones in your fingers separated by joints. The way you count how many phalanges you have in your finger is you take your finger and you bend it. So when you bend it, you can see that there is one bone, two bone, second bone, and the third bone right here. And they're all separated by a joint, which is a part of your finger that moves. So I want you to guess how many phalanges your thumb has. So bend it really quick and let me know. So unlike these four fingers, your thumb, when you bend it, there's only one joint. So you can see the two bones on either side of your finger. So when we're making the bones for our hand today, we're only going to be worrying about the bones which in our fingers, which are our phalanges. So the way that you're going to make your bones is that you're going to look at your hand and the place where it dips down right here at that bottom corner, I want you to draw a line across your hand. This is how you're going to measure the length of your straws. So we're going to start with our index finger, which is right next to our thumb right here. So what I want you to do is you're going to take your straw and you're going to measure from this dotted line in your palm to the end of the finger right there. And then that is going to be the length of the straws that you're going to need for the bones in this finger. And so I want you to take your scissors and carefully cut the straw. And so now you have a piece of straw for your index finger. And now what you're gonna do is you're gonna take this piece of straw and I want you to bend it in half and we're gonna cut it. And then take your scissors and cut in the middle. So now you have two pieces of straws and then you're gonna put one down and take the last second piece and then you're gonna bend it in half again. And then you're just gonna cut it. And then now we have our three pieces of straws, which are our three phalanges or bones in our index finger. All right, once you have your three pieces of straws cut, what I want you to do is go ahead and tape them onto your index finger. So you're first going to take the two smaller straws. Those are going to be at the top, like so, and then you're going to add your longer piece on the bottom. You're gonna take your little piece, and I just tape the first straw onto the very tip of the finger. And then you have your second small piece, and so you wanna place that, don't put the straws right next to each other because then your finger's not gonna be able to bend as well. I found that the bigger the space is in between the pieces of straws, the more lifelike your hand will be. So you don't need to measure, just eyeball it and put a little space in between the straws like that. And then you're gonna grab your little piece of tape that we cut before. And you wanna also make sure that these pieces of straws are in line. And so now I have my two small pieces of straws taped on. Now I have my third long piece and I'm going to tape that underneath it. And so as you can see, even though these are the bones in our fingers, it is spreading into our palm. This is not a 100% two scale model. If you wanna be super precise and measure your own finger and figure out the size of each bone in your finger and make it exact and super lifelike, you can. Just for this activity, we're just gonna be focusing on the three big pieces, which is a lot easier to work with. And so now your hand should look just like that. So you have your three phalanges, which are your three bones in your finger. So right now, if you have bones, bones don't move by themselves. Muscle is what moves bones. And something called tendons are what connects muscle to bone. So for example, when you have your hand, and the muscles in your forearm contract, it pulls on the tendons in your fingers, which causes them to curl up in a ball, which is what we're going to want our hand to do. And so for this activity, the string is going to act as our tendons. So when you pull on the string, it's what would happen if your muscles were to contract, right? You pull on the string, and then that effect will cause your fingers on your hand to curl up. So from the tip of the finger down, I would say make it even a little longer than that. So make it the string go past your hand. I would just eyeball it. The longer the better. You can always trim it, no worries. So I'm gonna take my string, I'm gonna cut it. Scissor safety. And then you're going to take, so this is an extra piece of straw that I had left over from the last finger, and I'm just gonna cut a small piece. Be careful when you cut these straws because they'll go flying. So here's just a small piece of straw. What I want you to do is you're gonna tie this piece of string around the straw. All right, now that I have a little piece of straw tied onto the end of my string, now what you're gonna wanna do is take the string and you're going to put it through your straws. So this is why it was important to make sure the straws were in line, right? And so it should look like this. And that's why you wanted to have this little, we tied on this little piece of straw at the end, was so that when we put the string on, the string's not just gonna go straight through the straws. It helps kind of be a stopper. So instead of taping your straws to the paper and then putting the string through, I would take your piece of string with the straw at the end and thread on your little pieces of straws. So make sure the two small ones go first. And so now you have your three bones, and then you just lay it on top. Super easy, quick way than trying to thread them through. Whenever I pull on the string, so imagine the muscles again in your forearm contracting, so that means bunching up, pulling together, and then it causes your finger to move, so that again the tendons connect the muscle to the bone, and the muscle is what makes your bones move. How cool is that? All right, so now what I want you to do is pause this video and continue this activity for the rest of the fingers. Remember, your thumb only has two bones, so you're only gonna wanna use a small piece of straw and a large piece of straw for that finger. Okay, now that you've finished all of your fingers, your hand should look something like this. So when you hold the bottom of your hand and you pull on all the strings, all the fingers will curl up. Process, the first step is to identify your problem. So your problem is that you have an exoskeleton hand that is not very exoskeleton-like. So we have to figure out a way to attach it to our hand. So remember, an exoskeleton is a wearable robotic device. It also needs to be able to move all of its fingers using only the hand it is attached on. So if I'm attaching it onto this hand, I cannot use this hand to flex these fingers. I need to figure out a way where this hand can pull on these strings and make the fingers move while I'm wearing it. The next steps of the engineering design process is the brainstorm and design phase. So think about what other materials you can use to help attach your exoskeleton hand to your own hand. So what does wearable mean to you? Does that mean it needs to fit comfortably? It needs to have good mobility and move well? Does it need to be fashionable? What does wearable mean to you? And make sure to add it into your design when you're brainstorming. And lastly, don't forget to build and test it. So you're gonna build some sort of extension off of your hand to attach it to your arm, and then have a competition with yourself and see if you can pick up a paper ball using your exoskeleton hand. And don't forget to share your solution. Engineers don't just build and test things, they use their creativity to come up with new ways of how to do things and new designs. So please post your design on social media and share it using hashtag STEMSpaceAtHome. We're on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Make sure to ask parent permission before you do so. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.